Power rates are expected to go up next month. Oil prices also seen to increase for the third straight week on Tuesday. Alvin El Chico reports.
Despite conservation efforts in the household, consumer Lady Lean's electricity bill has been going up since late last year.
Hindi nga din po alam eh. Baka ang mangyari nito, na, baka patayin na lang din namin muna yung rep. Kasi pataas ang pataas eh, di naman tumataas ang sahod ng buwanan, di ba?
Consumers may see higher bills in the coming months as the Energy Regulatory Commission lifts the suspension in the charging of the feed-in tariff allowance or FITAL starting February. This almost 4 centavo per kilowatt hour charge goes to the payment of developers of renewable sources of energy like solar, wind, and hydro. The FITAL has been suspended for more than a year due to surplus in funds collected from consumers over the years.
Ito pong huling bisita namin sa fund nitong katapusan ng December hanggang itong early January, nakita natin na medyo manipis na yung fund. Kailangan na nating simulan ulit yung pagpuno ng pondo nitong feed-in tariff.
ERC Chairperson Mona Lisa Di Malanta has also alerted cooperatives and utilities nationwide to prepare for the summer season when supply is critical and electricity prices tend to go up.
Pati yung mga bulsa natin, kailangan nating ihanda dahil usually pag summer months, talagang nagkakagipitan ng supply at kasunod ng gipit na supply, konting higher adjustment ng ating mga power rates.
Meanwhile, another round of oil price hike looms next Tuesday. So far, with one trading day left, diesel and gasoline prices are up by more than 50 centavos per liter.
Idadagdag po natin yung possible premium nitong linggo na to. Unfortunately, baka mas malaki pa po, ano? And ang nakikita naman ho natin for today's trading, mukhang pataas pa rin po, ano? So aside from yung premium, baka yung sa MAPS week on week pa lang po, medyo talagang lumaki pa po yung ating projected increase for next week.
Nag-escalate kasi yung tension sa Middle East. Kasama na dito yung pag-atake ng mga barko na dumadaan sa Red Sea. And then nagkaroon din ng atake yung Iranian missile na anti-target is Syria at Iraq.
Jetty Petroleum President Leo Belia says if there's no geopolitical tension in the Middle East, fuel prices could be lower as global demand remains weak.
Nagsisiso po yung price, no? Yung may tug of war, kumbaga. May isang angle na talaga nagpapaakyat, yung isang angle naman ay medyo pumipigil. Actually, kung wala po yung sabihin natin na Middle East conflict, mukhang yung fundamentals po ay talagang pababa po talaga yung price.
3 weeks into 2024, there is already a more than 1 peso net increase for diesel and 30 centavos for gasoline in the Philippines. Alvin El Chico, ABS-CBN News.
Over 1,000 jeepney routes nationwide remain unconsolidated less than 2 weeks before the January 31 deadline for consolidation lapses. This is according to Philippine Transport Regulator, LTFRB, which says in Metro Manila alone, over 300 routes may be dissolved due to unconsolidated drivers. But the regulator assures the public there will be no transport crisis come February 1st, since 76% of jeepney routes nationwide have consolidated.
Wala po kami nakikitang crisis. As of now, po, yung mga rotang yun na nabakantihan po, may mga handang mga iba-ibang modes of public transport, jeep, UV, bus, and sa Metro Manila Rail na pwede pong pumuno doon sa mga naiwanan ng mga hindi nag-consolidate.
We have already mapped out all these routes in Metro Manila. Ilan ba dito yung 60% na nag-consolidate, ilan po yung less than 60% at ilan ho yung zero nga. Meron hong sasagot na ibang modes or ibang rota po.
Farmers groups welcome the temporary suspension of onion imports amid a surplus in local supply. Let's get more details from our correspondent, Jose Carretero. Jose, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Vivian. Samahang industriya ng agrikultura o SINAG welcomed the announcement of Agriculture Secretary Francisco Chu Laurel Jr. to temporarily suspend the importation of onions. SINAG President Rosen Duso said the suspension will help the onion farmers in the country, particularly in Nueva Ecija, sell their produce at a good price. Harvest of white onions, according to Duso, has already started in Nueva Ecija. he said, farmers are selling their produce at 18 to 20 pesos per kilo, which is a break-even price. One of the reasons, according to So, is markets are still dominated with supply of imported white onions. So thanked the Agriculture Department for their prompt action on their request days ago to halt importation of onions since harvest of white onions will start to peak this February while the red onion will peak in March. The suspension of import is beneficial to the onion farmers. According to So, to stabilize the price of onions, especially that more onion farmers have planted onions this planting season because of the good price and high demand last year. So said, for farmers to earn farm gate prices must be at least 30 to 45 pesos per kilo. The suspension will be until May or could still be extended until July, according to So. He said, there is, however, a need to reassess it after 45 days to check if local supply of onions could still provide the demand of the market. This is to avoid possible spike in prices, he added. Meanwhile, So said infestation of armyworms in some onions plantation in Bungabong, Nueva Ecija will not affect the supply of onions in the country. He said only 3 barangays have been infested with armyworms, locally called as jarabas, and is now under control. Vivian.
Thank you for that update, Jose Carretero. The Philippine Health Department cautions the public against the use of glutathione. This following the reported death of a woman in Quezon City due to alleged complications from the product. Rafael Bosano with the details.
The Food and Drug Administration reminds the public that glutathione is not approved for use in the Philippines apart from being part of cisplatin chemotherapy.
Kung hindi po nag-apply yung establishment po para sa product ng glutathione, then hindi po covered or hindi po nag-apply for cisplatin chemotherapy, then for other causes not mentioned po in the application, wala pong approval by the FDA.
The regulator admits that glutathione products is offered widely in aesthetic clinics as skin whiteners. But the Philippine Medical Association says the public must exercise caution, especially when mixing glutathione with other drugs.
Kailangan kasi chine-check din yan, ano, kung bangga-bangga ba yung mga epekto niya. Doon tayo pwede magkaroon ng problema pag nagkaroon ng drug interaction. Tapos may tinatawag pa na allergy. Kung allergic tayo doon sa preparation, pwede kasing hindi yung mismong glutathione tayo allergic, pero yung mga pangkap niya ba?
News of a woman's death just hours after allegedly getting glutathione and stem cell therapy have recently made the rounds online. The Philippine Health Department says it is investigating this case.
I've asked our regional office to investigate that clinic because it's a clinic and it's giving IV glutathione. Namatay yung patient, you gave glutathione. And number two, I don't know kung namatay sa IV glutathione kasi sabi dun sa news article, nag-stem cell din. May license ba sila to use stem cell?
Based on an administrative order, only 6 facilities have been accredited by the DOH to perform human stem cell and cell-based or cellular therapy in the Philippines.
When people say safe yan, stem cell galing sa sarili mo, pero once you bring it out of the body and you process it, at ibinalik mo sa body, may possibility ma-infect ka. So that's what the DOH checks, that your facility follows sterility standards, that your devices are clean.
The health agency admits there is a need to improve the public's knowledge on glutathione and stem cell therapy. But despite the warning, demand for glutathione shots is not expected to decline as people continue to desire fairer skin. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine government urged to impose measures to combat illegal activities online. This after authorities found cybercrime cases tripled last year. Nico Bawa reports.
The NBI Cybercrime Division arrested these 5 men along Commonwealth Avenue. One of them attempted to dispose the marked money. The agents retrieved SIM cards registered to e-wallets, which the suspects were allegedly selling. Meanwhile, 2 suspects were arrested in an entrapment operation for selling their registered e-wallets or GCash accounts in East Avenue. One of the suspects allegedly acted as a middleman between those who are selling and buying the accounts. The illegal activity starts with a social media post seeking to buy e-wallet accounts. The price of each GCash account can fetch up to 800 pesos depending on the credit limit of the account. Once the buyer and the seller agree on the price, they meet in person so the seller can register personal information on the app, including face recognition.
Dahil po meron na pong face card yung GCash, eh, kaya kailangan po nila talaga mismo yung owner ng GCash. Paliwanag po, pagkatapos ng face card, bayad po agad. May commission lang po, 100K limit, 1K po ang binili nila, tapos 800 po ang bigay ko sa magbebenta.
According to the NBI, these accounts are being used by scammers for illegal transactions.
Dalawang modus, either for sale or kaya for rent. Kasi ngayon sa GCash, may feature na within 90 days, nag-automatic nag-deactivate. So kailangan mo mag-reface scan ka uli. So parang monthly ka lang, may collection ka na. Kasi pag nag-reface scan, babalik na naman sa'yo yung buyer. Oh, pa-face scan ka uli. Oh.
In this modus, scammers skirt accountability after deceiving their victims.
Clever yung kanilang style eh. Kasi pag ikaw investigator, medyo malilito ka sa track mo o sa path mo kung saan mo sisimulan yung lead. Ang modus kasi, kung ako mayari ng GCash account, ibibenta ko sa'yo, tapos ikaw, ito yung gagamitin mo for your online activity, whether it be legal or illegal, as the case may be. No? So kung ikaw investigator, sa point of view ng investigator, nangyari yung crime, ikaw yung may hawak, pero sa record namin, nakapangalan sa seller. Tama? So hindi ka namin pwedeng hulihin kasi ang nakapangalan doon na perpetrator, yung may tunay na may-ari ng account, yung nagbenta sa iyo.
The suspects say they regret selling their personal GCash accounts and claimed that they did not know that it was illegal.
Nakita ko po sa online.
Ano nalagay sa online?
Naghanap sila ng ano. Eh, sakto po, wala kaming pares na budget. Ako gusto kong ano, makakain. Kasi nag-away po kasi kami ng asawa ko.
According to the NBI, the number of cybercrimes increased by 200% last year. They are calling for the passage of proposed laws to combat cybercrimes.
At the moment kasi wala pa tayong specific law, so medyo rampant itong nangyayari ngayon na bagong modus nila. Pwede niyang laruin yung batas eh. Unless may pasa talaga yon at may implement na, medyo deterrence na yan.
The suspects have been jailed for violating the Access Device Law and the Cybercrime Prevention Act. In a statement, GCash thanked the NBI for the arrests since they both have the same objective in protecting the hard-earned money of account holders. Nico Bawa, ABS-CBN News.
Now here's something that will help you fulfill your travel goals. Affordable travel deals awaited an upcoming travel tour and trade expo. As Jeffrey Arnaez tells us, this couldn't come at a better time, with air fares expected to be cheaper next month.
The best travel deals here and abroad up for grabs. After the Philippine Travel Agencies Association announced its 31st Travel Tour and Trade Expo. Mark your calendars as the event happens on February 2 to 4 at the SMX Convention Center in Pasay City. This all-in-one expo features more than 200 exhibitors occupying 700 booths from the travel industry.
It's going to be the biggest and the best ever that we're going to have the Travel Tour Expo, and we have the whole world at our hands. Dunho, they can plan their destination, where they want to go, and get the best promos ever from all the hotels, the airlines, and all the travel agencies.
Among the top destinations for local and foreign tourists in the country are Palawan, Boracay, and Bohol. Meanwhile, South Korea tops the list of international destinations for Filipinos.
Dahil K-pop, so Korea is one of the best destinations that all Filipinos want to go to. Also Japan, but of course, bakit ka pupunta pa sa US kung meron na tayong Universal Studios sa Singapore at saka Disneyland sa Hong Kong?
Organizers say travelers should plan early to get the best deals.
They have to plan ahead para mas makatipid sila. Kasi kung magta-travel sila, gusto nila at mag-travel bukas, eh syempre, napakamahal ho yun. Pero if you will plan ahead, you book 6 months or 12 months ahead, the better.
Meanwhile, the price of airfare is expected to decrease in February after the Civil Aeronautics Board announced the reduction of the fuel surcharge to level 5 from the previous level 6.
I believe that every peso counts. So with the fuel surcharges going lower, I think mas marami na ho tayong mapupuntahan ngayon.
However, some airlines may not lower airfare rates just yet.
For the surcharges, sir, we set deadlines for that. Also, we cannot lower the fare by February because the fuel that we have, the fuel reserve that we have, noon pa namin nabili. So hindi siya pwedeng ibaba because we are still using the reserve fuel that we have on that price.
But according to the Philippine Airlines, they will implement it once the Civil Aeronautics Board sets a date.
Fuel prices is always one of the factors that determine prices, no, for air tickets. The CAB determines when we're supposed to apply the adjustment. So if it's level, so we always implement naman because we will be penalized if we don't follow the set policy of the CAB. So definitely, if there's a date that we're supposed to implement these adjustments in fuel, then we comply. All airlines comply to that.
Jeffrey Hernandez, ABS-CBN News.
Push to amend the Constitution, the Philippine Interior Department warns it will sanction village officials participating in the signature drive for the People's Initiative. ABS-CBN correspondent Michael Delizo joins us on the line for more. Michael, good afternoon.
Hi, Vivian. Good afternoon. The Department of Interior and Local Government said village officials who are proven to have any participation on the signature campaign for People's Initiative to amend the charter may face sanctions. The ALG Undersecretary Chito Valmosina said the department has been verifying information that some village officials are involved in the signature drive, but no formal complaints have been lodged so far. Valmosina clarified that village officials should not campaign the People's Initiative, let alone comment on the matter. He added village halls should not also be used for the gathering of signatures. Valmosina further advised village officials to monitor the signature campaign, observe peace and order, and investigate incidents of harassment or coercion. According to the Commission on Elections, 674 municipalities and cities have received signature forms as of 5 p.m. of January 19. Back to you, Vivian.
Thank you for that report, Michael Delizo. The Philippine House leadership maintains there is no order from the lower chamber to coerce or offer cash to the public to support the People's Initiative Charter Change campaign. That's after Vice President Sara Duterte flagged the alleged buying of signatures, which she likened to vote buying. House Deputy Majority Leader Erwin Tulfo, however, denied this.
I really don't know kung saan ang galing na dinoduktor, pinupunduhan, hindi bibigyan ng ayuda kung di pipirma dyan sa People's Initiative na yan. Kung sila man, may naririnig siya na may mga suhulan dyan, mga congressman, mga mayor, mga barangay captain, siguro at their own initiative na yun. Pero wala ho kasi talaga, I'm telling you now, wala pong instruction mula po sa taas na magkaroon po ng suhulan.
The camp of Philippine Senator Jinggoy Estrada needs to carefully weigh their legal pursuit. That advice comes from the former lawyer of Pork Barrel Scam whistleblowers, attorney Levito Baligod. He warns Estrada may still be convicted of plunder if he takes his bribery charges to the Supreme Court. The anti-graft court on Friday acquitted Estrada of plunder in the multi-billion peso pork barrel scam, but it convicted the senator of one count of direct bribery and two counts of indirect bribery.
Kung hindi na siya mag-apela, makukulong siya ng 4 to 5 more years. Pero kung mag-apela siya, no? Or, well, una, mag-file siya ng motion for reconsideration. Depende na naman sa decision ng Santigan Bayan. Kung i-affirm ng Santigan Bayan, aakyat si Senator sa Supreme Court. At kung umakyat siya sa Supreme Court ay mabubuksan muli ang buong kaso at meron pang tsansa na makita ng Korte Suprema na merong plunder ito. So baka makonvict pa siya ng plunder. Magiging penal yung decision ng Sandigan Bayan after 15 days, no? Without doing anything. Or 60 days kung hindi siya mag-file ng certiorari. Pero yun po ang puzzle ngayon sa mga lawyers ni Senator Estrada din at saka sa kanya mismo kung ano yung legal remedy na kanilang tatahakin.
Ligod adds Estrada's fate should serve as a warning to other government officials.
Ang gusto sana nating mensahe dito ay ang mga kaso po na ito na finile natin noon ay isang paalala po sana sa mga opisyales natin, no, sa pamahalaan, na maaaring sa darating na mga panahon ay pananagutan din nila yung kanilang mga ginawang kalokohan. Kaya paalala ito na sana ay maging seryoso sila sa panunungkulan sa ating bayan at panatilihin nila yung kasabihan na public office is a public trust.
The Philippine government says it is open to allowing international investigators into the country to probe the Duterte administration's drug war. That declaration made Thursday by Manila's Justice Secretary during an interview with Tokyo-based Kyodo News. Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla says foreign investigators may be allowed to gather evidence but should comply with the legal process. The seeming change in tune by the Philippine government follows President Marcos's remarks in November that Manila is studying whether to rejoin the International Criminal Court. The Marcos administration earlier vowed to cease communication with the Hague-based tribunal after it denied its appeal to stop the ICC prosecutor's probe of the anti-drug campaign. The Philippines pulled out of the ICC in 2019 during the Duterte administration. It has since insisted that the court has no jurisdiction over the country.